the water to dilute the boundary, to blur the boundary of the finger, so which will result in difference in complexity. So we just take the four in the left-hand side into the consideration, and then we measure the average length of the fingers to find that the trend is very close to the theoretical line, and at low concentration, there is a greater inaccuracy, which is also caused by the dilute of finger age by the water. So, however, when we plot the complexity against the average length, we also find that the two experiments with water dilution do not follow the trend. So if we took the only the four experiment in the left hand side, we also find that there is a positive correlation between the average length of the finger and the complexity. And also
1 minute remaining.
Similar, so we also analyzed the finger growth rate in the experiment with different concentration of acrylic. So, and we can find that at the higher the complexity, the faster the finger growing rate will be. So this is the line with the serration. And however, we found that the speed is not a fixed volume. Yes, so but will slow and slow down in, and finally tend to like a terminal speed. So this trend is very similar to the droplet thickness, which tends to be a terminal volume. So on the right hand side, it is a plot of the liquid thickness against time. And using the total area divided by the liquid total volume divided by the liquid area. So therefore,
I'm sorry, your time is up. We have to move on to the next page, which is 2 minutes of questions from the opponents.
The surface tension and the viscous force to pull each other, which cause the fingering to happen.
Okay, I'm sorry. we've run out of time for a clarifying question, so we're going to move on to the next stage.
I have given the opponent presentation rights now, so you're good to go whenever you are ready.
他有没有可能有两台装置？ 算了，他就你来不及了，你来不及就算了，不要不要，哎，来不及了。 然后提醒他，人家扣进 remark 是1分钟，不是2分钟。哦哦，对。他要自己扣。
关起来吧，你看自己的看，算了，我刚才讲不看。
好， 这穿得了吗？
嗯。
穿得了。这里放得了图片吗？这里放得了图片。
You must start sharing the screen now, otherwise you're going to spend the next 2 days watching the speech. Do you have any technical issues?
Why is my voice a girl, but it looks like a girl? Is it 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 a girl?
Really?
Okay. Please start the clock for the opposition speech.
Yeah, it's very rough.
Hello everyone, I am
from
the
town.
I'm sharing
the phone. Show me the phone. I don't
know what
to do. I don't
know what to do.
She's doing so.
Please, in the next round, I ask you to share your screen to the board in the preparation part. Okay, start the clock again, please. please move the fuck on to the next stage? And please, reporter, can you share your presentation again?
You've got just over 10 minutes for your discussion of the North.
Thank you. But as far as we know, Darcy's law is used to calculate
the movement of liquid in porous media. How do you explain that device?
Okay, so basically, we use the acrylic pen, and if we take the acrylic pen in microscopic scale, we can also consider it as a porous media as well.
So you assume that the fingering is happening on the inside of the media?
The acrylic pen and the alcohol mixture is just a little bit. They can also they can mix together. So I believe it is on the surface of the acrylic pen. So it can also be considered as the porous media that can use Darcy's law to explain this kind of movement.
I'm sorry, but if the mixture is flowing on the surface of the acrylic pen. How does it make use of the porous nature of the acrylic paint?
Because we consider the acrylic paint as porous media, and so the movement on that part we can consider.
Yes,
we can
use the law requires meant inside the porous media, so we think that Darcy's law's application is inappropriate here. Thank you. And also, did you consider the effects of the temperature since you discussed the evaporation?
Yes. We fixed the temperature as the same 10 degrees because we know that the temperature will affect the viscosity very much. So we keep that our acrylic pan and also the water based in the.
Did you just did you control temperature or did you investigate it?
We control the temperature as the same degree.
Okay, I advise you to investigate the effects of temperature on your phenomenon. We think it can also be considered as an independent variable in the question. Thank you. And also, can I see where you analyze the fractal dimensions?
Fractal dimension. We use the box counting dimension. We didn't really analyze the numbers of the dimension, but which we define the dimension as between 1 and 2. So if the dimension is 1 and 2, we can define it as a fractal.
So your result is that the fractal dimension is between 1 and 2?
Yes.
But as you can see, we live in a three-dimensional world, and the whole possibilities of fractal patterns, like in the physical world we live in, is between 1 and 3.
Because we just consider it as a 2.
Yeah. Do you think the scale that you gain is a little bit too broad?
But 1 and 3 is because you think as a cubic mold. However, we just take a picture from the outside, so it's just a two-dimensional picture, so that we count it to 1 and 2.
Did you use box counting method 2 in your experiment?
We counted the box of. We counted and we measured. We make sure that it is between 1 and 2, so we can call it fractal. Like we count the dimension of this. Yeah.
More of the process on here, but we would like to see how you achieve such results.
We did use the.
The scale of the dimension, whether it's between 1 and 2 or between 2 or 3, it determines what method you can use to analyze it. And apparently you use the Boxer method, which already includes the assumption that it is between 1 and 2, but you did not do any theory or experiment to validate that assumption. Am I correct?
Method counts the dimension in my experience to make sure that the length that vector is truly like fit the theory that we used in the boxing dimension.
Okay. Please make sure you present it better next time. And I would suggest you to consider the possibility that Sandman-Taylor instability is not a main contributor to this effect. Like, I don't think we have much time. In our experiment, I can see that a ring of droplets is formed on the edge of your fingering, and so I am just guessing that maybe it could have been, the fingering could might as well be an effect of the Marabouille spray.
Yeah, we did experiments that we found the importance of Marangoni effects. So in the left-hand side, we saw the alcohol evaporation, so that won't cause the Marangoni effect. So in this way, it won't happen like the fractal.
Thank you. We've gone over time. Opponent, you have 1 minute to summarize the discussion.
Okay, so now I will summarize the discussion. The first thing is that I think the whole mechanism the report discussed is not appropriate because I think Marangoni effect is the more dominating effect that happened in the phenomenon. And also the wetting theory does not apply to this theory because the two the mixture and the phase is mutually dissolvable, and that would make the wetting theory not applicable. And okay, so and also the reporter said that she discussed the change of the two the change of the two liquid properties over time, but I did not see any both quantitative explanation or investigation on that. And also, we discussed that
So we have 1 minute, concluding closing remarks from the reporter. Please, Ling Chuan. Okay, Chinese Taipei's reporter, you have 1 minute.
You should have presenter rights now.
Thank you. Okay, start the clock, please.
We can't hear you, you're muted.
Sorry. Okay, can I start again?
Yeah, reset the clock.
Okay, thank you. So, hello everyone, I'm the reporter from Team Chinese Taipei, and here's my concluding remark. So first, we mentioned that the two droplet motion is the diffusion part is caused by the difference in the surface tension, and which will cause the Marangoni flow. And the fractal finger is caused by the instability of the viscosity difference. So, both of these two parts are very important to this phenomenon to happen. Cannot just focus on just each one. And for the dynamics part, we mentioned about the growing velocity, which is the concentration of the droplet. And for the geometric part, we mentioned the complexity of the fingers, which is the concentration of the acrylic pen. And also we mentioned the length of the finger. And for the complexity, it is the total length that divided by the total area. And we also use the capillary number to quantitatively find the boundary of the finger. So,
you can finish that sentence.
Just like this, thank you.
Thank you. Right, that's come to the end of that stage. And we have now 5 minutes for jury questions. If you want to ask a question, jury, then I guess your hand up, and I can give you the word. So who wants to start?
Going to happen in this experiment?
Like,
Like what were you bringing?
I mean, are you suggesting that it should go up to 3, or do you think it's appropriate just to consider between 1 and 2?
No, I believe 1 and 2 is the right scale that the fractal dimension triangle curve, the fractal fingering foot, I think it is too broad for such an effect. I believe that it should be more specified, or it would be meaningless.
Okay, thank you. So now we have the next phase, which is the jury grading, which will be 5 minutes. And jurors, you have to put your grades into the CC with the sliders, and then put in your final into grade, and then do save and close. And Izzy will let me know when everyone has finished grading. So I'm just going to mute my microphone and camera for now.
好像我第十，好像十二块钱一件，然后拿走了，删掉一件，不要用了。